Hi, my name is Morten, and in this video I will show you how you can apply a code sent to you by Ucommerce. This video is part of the Ucommerce Academy. Before we get started, let's discuss a little bit what this actually means. Well, during development, you might run into issues. You might run into bugs in the platform. You might run into extensions that you need to make. You will maybe reach out to Ucommerce in the support situations. And in some cases, we will send some code to you that will help you out reaching your end goal. This could be a patch in the platform. It could be a little code snippet that you can use to debug the code to figure out what goes on. It could also be a code snippet that helps you get started with an extension that you need to apply to the platform. In any case, if we send some code to you, you need to apply this to a website. And this video here will show you how to achieve just that. So let's try to set up a thought scenario and apply the code changes. Let's get started. All right, so I reached out to Ucommerce to get help with an issue with our facet indexer in Ucommerce. I want to change the behavior of this, or there's a bug in it, regardless of the origin of my inquiry with the support. I got a hotfix for it. So they say to me, I just need to register it with the same component ID as below. So I have two configuration components here that are relevant to any Ucommerce component in the IOC container. So the model for changing the behavior of this or debugging is it's the same regardless of what kind of component it is. So I have the configuration for it, and I also have the class for it, which is coming from the Ucommerce solution. So we need to apply this in our own project somehow. So let's see how we can achieve that. So I will download the file, and I will copy it. And now we need to get it into our solution for the project that we're running. In this case, I'll just dump it into my Ucommerce Masterclass Business Logic project. This could also be a website project that has the CMS and Ucommerce installed through NuGet or whatever. In any case, we need to have our code registered inside some assembly that will be running under the website. How your project is structured, that can be any way you wish. So let's try to create a new folder here called patch. Put in the file, and now in my Ucommerce Masterclass solution, I need to find this particular file here and import it into the project. So I will include it in the project. So now we actually have the code coming from Ucommerce running directly inside our default product facet indexer class here. But one thing needs to happen. First, we need to change the namespace so that it matches our project name and project structure. So it will now, the namespace where this type is now present in will be Ucommerce Masterclass Business Logic Patch. So far, so good. Now we can actually build it and compile it and see it running under any of our Ucommerce projects. But this is not enough. Now we have the class, but we still need to actually register the type inside our running website. So let's go back and see what Ucommerce writes. Here's the hotfix for it. Just register it with the same component ID as below. So we have these two components here that we now need to change. It can be one or multiple component based on what the use case is. So I will take those two components, and we now need to put them into our apps folder where we are certain that they will be overwritten or will override whatever default functionality Ucommerce provides out of the box. So I will create another folder here called patch, and inside that we will need a new configuration file. So we need to find that. Let's also call it patch. So our configuration file needs to consist of our components, and then the two components that I have pasted in directly from the email. So based on how the IEC container in Ucommerce works, is that the ID that we are reusing will override the default components that has already been registered in Ucommerce. So whenever some component is construct injecting this service type that we have in our component, our components that we are registering now will be resolved instead of the default Ucommerce ones. So if you need to apply a patch, you can always override the default component by reusing the same component ID as found in the Ucommerce core solution. So that is what we need to do. Now we have the components in here, but we still need to register our types, because right now they are just overriding the other component from the Ucommerce configuration files with the same type as Ucommerce already has. So this is why we imported our component here into our website project. So we need to change the type to match our component instead. So we need the namespace. And we need the type name. The reason that we are registering this class two times is that this class here is actually responsible for having business logic for two different service types. And that's why the same class is registered twice, but with multiple service types as specified here. It can also be a single one. So now we have the namespace specified, and we have the class name here, default product facet indexer, which has also been entered. So we have the namespace and we have the type name. So we also need to reuse the assembly name like this. Ucommerce masterclass business logic. All right, so now we have imported the class that we were sent from an email. We took the configuration they sent along as well, and we put that all into our solution. So when we build this and deploy it to our website, our type is now the running type instead of the default Ucommerce one. In this case, it's the default product facet indexer, which will take the Ucommerce data and map it into Raven and put it over to RavenDB. So if we want to test this, we need to go in and either run the scratch indexer in Ucommerce or save a product in the backend where this code here will be triggered. In any case, now it is running and we can debug the code by attaching a debugger and put our breakpoint wherever we need. So regardless of this being a patch that just needs to be applied, a code piece where you want to debug a certain component, the process that I went through is the same. You need to take the code, import it into a project, change the namespace, and then apply the configuration for your type by overriding with the same component ID. And that is all you have to do. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.